Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. It is Karina from Paradium Thrifts and we are back with another monthly What Sold video. October was my highest sales month to date, so I am super excited to be sharing with you guys some of the pieces that sold as well as my overall stats. If you guys didn't know, Poshmark came out with a closet insights feature on the app and you're able to see all of the data from your past sales, from your current inventory, and I just think it is such an amazing tool. This is what we've been waiting for such a long time. So now that we have this available, I can share with you guys a little bit more of an insider scoop to how my sales went. Now before we begin, I want to share that today's video is sponsored by Vendu. If it weren't for Vendu, I don't think I would have had my highest sales month to date. They have been a total game changer. I have used other cross-listing services before, but Vendu just blows everybody else out of the water. For those of you guys who are not familiar with Vendu, they allow cross-listing, relisting, delisting, and they even have a feature where you can check your analytics across all different platforms. So it is such a helpful tool. If you guys want to try them out, I have an affiliate link down in the description box. You can use the code Karina for 25% off. I am also co-hosting a listing challenge with Vendu over on Facebook. The only requirement is that you do have an active membership with Vendu. So if you don't, go ahead and sign up. If you are already a member, you can join the group. Everybody shares tips and motivation to get your listings done. You also get a chance to win some prizes if you participate in some of the posts. So that's very exciting. I hope I can connect with some of you guys over there. So definitely check those links out and let's get back to the video. So like I said earlier, October was my best sales month to date. I am so proud. I wasn't even really expecting that I was going to reach the goal that I did, considering these past few months I've been like just shy of reaching my goals, but this month I blew it out of the water. I actually lowered my expectations this month and I still reached what I wanted to in the first place. So in the month of October, I made a total sales across all platforms of $6,756.61. Now, of course, that is gross sales. That is not including my cost of goods or the fees of all the different platforms that I sell on, but my goal originally was 5,000. That's the one that I lowered it down to. I've been wanting to hit that 6,000 because I haven't hit it since like April, I think. So I was very, very excited about it. Most of my sales, as usual, were made on Poshmark, but I made a few sales on The RealReal, eBay, Mercari, and I even made one sale on Depop, which was awesome. So now I'm gonna share with you guys some of the sales that I made, and then we will go into more of the analytics. So the first sale that I wanted to share with you guys was a retail arbitrage find. I actually went to Nordstrom Rack for this piece during their Clear the Rack sale, and my dumbass didn't read any of the signs, so I thought it was like anything that was on sale was included in the red tag, but it was only clothing and apparel. So I had loaded my cart up with shoes, only to be told at the cashier that none of the shoes had the additional clearance, which was fine. I only left with a few things, but that was including this pair of Tory Burch 70 millimeter lug sole brown leather boots. And for some reason, these were marked at $20 and there was like nothing wrong with them. So I decided to pick them up. And I'm really happy I did because they sold within 2 days for $170. Minus the Poshmark fee, I made $136. I believe I had these listed for around $200 and then somebody made me an offer for $170 and I accepted. It was such a quick flip. I wish I could find more shoes like this. But this is actually a style that I mentioned in one of my style trend videos. This lug sole is super popular right now. So if you find something like this while you're out sourcing, definitely pick it up. The next thing that sold was this Smith, I think that's how you pronounce it, blue cotton linen classic blazer. Now this sold for $80. Minus the Poshmark fee, I earned $64, but I had this sitting for a while. I honestly thought that this was gonna sell a lot quicker. This was my first time finding this brand and it's been on my Bolo list, but if I find this, I will definitely pick it up again. This was even like an older style and it still did pretty well, so not mad at it. Next is an item from one of my consignment clients. It was a pair of these Fendi brown leather peep toe stilettos. Now these sold for $94. They did have some wear on them and I did disclose that in the listing, but they sold for $94. Minus the Poshmark fee, I earned $75.20. And then me and my consignment client split that in half. So I got about like $38 or so from that. So my next sale, I know for sure it was because of Vendu that I made this sale, but it was this Majorelle Danielle maxi dress. And the reason I say it was because of Vendu is because I had it listed for a while, and after a bunch of price drops and all of that, I think I had it listed for about like $50 or so. Somebody offered me $30 and I declined it because I was like, there's no way I'm getting rid of this dress for $30. So I ended up going onto Vendu and using their delist and relist feature. Refresh the listing, raise the price back up to $120, and the next day I received an offer from the same person who offered me $30, $100. Now I have no idea if they knew that it was the same listing. Usually when I have the same buyer that was lowballing me in the past see that I relisted it, they get kind of upset. This buyer offered me $100, I accepted, and I didn't hear anything from them. They gave me 5 stars, so I hope they're happy with it, but they knew exactly how much that dress was worth. But that just shows you it is super important to relist your items and even increase the price if you know your item is worth something. Just hold to it, stick to your guns, relist it, raise the price, and a sale will come. So I don't know if I even said this, but it sold for $100. After Poshmark fees, I earned $80. This was something that I bought at Buffalo Exchange, and I think I paid like their full price for it, which was around $30, which is why I wasn't comfortable selling it for $30. Now my next two sales that I want to share with you guys are from my most recent denim haul. If you guys haven't watched that, I will link that up above. But I found a whole bunch of denim pieces, and just two pieces out of everything that I picked up have paid for over half of what I spent. So that was really exciting. The first one that sold were these Mother the Hustler Sidewinder jeans. I feel like with Mother denim, it can be a hit or miss. I know that it is a very like bolo brand, but a lot of the styles don't sell that well, in my opinion. Like for example, if I ever find the Looker Frey style, I tend to pass on those because those do not sell for nearly as much as some of the other styles. But this is a true bolo when it comes to Mother denim. It's like a flare leg with these slits down the side. All the comp sold for over $100, so I was very confident that I was gonna make a good profit on this. I sold my pair for $114, so PoshRVA automatically sent an offer for me for $114 plus free shipping, and a buyer accepted. So after all the fees, after the free shipping and everything, I earned $83.75, which is still a pretty good flip, especially since it only took like a few days for this item to sell as well. The other denim piece is probably my favorite from that whole haul, and it was this pair of Redone Originals 70s Stovepipe High-Rise Jeans. This is another really popular style of denim in this brand. Again, I think there are some Redone jeans that don't do as well as others. This is definitely one of the most sought-after styles, so you can definitely charge a little bit more for it. I sold my pair for $125. Minus the Poshmark fee, I earned $100. So just off those two pairs, I earned about $200. Moving on to eBay. My eBay sales have been picking up a little bit, which is great. I'm very happy about that. It just seems like the most random things sell on there. One of my goals for November is to definitely pump up my eBay sales, so I'm gonna have to start listing consistently instead of bulk listing on there. But I made a pretty good sale on here. This was a vintage Prada women's zip-up hooded puffer jacket, and when this sold, I checked on Poshmark to go like delete the listing, and I had it listed on Poshmark for $60, or around $60. This ended up selling on eBay for $150. Now the reason that there's like a price discrepancy is because when I had originally listed on both platforms, I had listed at $150. However, on Poshmark, since I frequently do price drops and all of that, the price has gone down significantly. But since I don't do that on eBay, the price remained at that original $150. And that's one of the things that I kind of love about cross-listing, is that you leave some pieces on some platforms and you don't touch them, and sometimes those are the ones that sell. So Poshmark, since it is a little bit more high maintenance and you have to do a little bit more to make sales, the prices of your sales can go down. Now this is just from my experience. I don't know how everybody else has been doing, but that's just from what I have noticed. This has also been true for me on other platforms like Tradesy, sometimes even Mercari. Things will sell for full price on those while I have price dropped them on Poshmark. I do want to add that on eBay I offer free shipping when I can. I believe I offered free shipping on this jacket, but that was a mistake. I usually offer free shipping on things that weigh under a pound, and then anything above that I try to charge, but I think I might have forgotten to change that on this one. The last item that I want to share with you that sold in the month of October was actually a Depop sale, and this kind of lighted the fire under me to start cross-listing on Depop even more. But this was another piece that I had cross-listed, and it had price dropped a crazy amount on Poshmark, and it sold for full price on Depop. So it was this vintage 1990s Kurt Cobain graphic band t-shirt. I actually found this at the bins, and it had been cut. It had been DIY'd by somebody, which was such a bummer because the original shirt was like a true vintage band tee, and the fully intact pieces go for quite a bit. I wasn't sure how this muscle tee was gonna go since somebody had like DIY cut it. But I had price dropped this all the way down to, I think, like $30 on Poshmark. It sold for $100 on Depop. I offered free shipping on this because it literally weighed nothing, and I was so happy about this. So now I'm gonna try to cross this a little bit more onto Depop. I think that's gonna be another goal of mine in October. So I'm just gonna do a quick little overview over the things that I sold on The RealReal, because this was, again, my highest sales month that I've ever made on The RealReal. And I don't send stuff in there often. I probably should, but I just haven't been finding that many like designer high-end things lately, so I haven't been able to send any boxes in. But I did send a bunch of stuff in like a couple months ago, and I was able to bring in an extra $669 from The RealReal, which is crazy for me. I know that there's a bunch of people who like sell on The RealReal regularly, so their commissions are a bit higher, but I was very, very excited about that. So some of the things that sold that I just want to share really quick with you guys was this Max Mara virgin wool coat. It sold on the platform for $263.50. My commission, so what I was paid out, was $158.10, which is pretty crazy considering all I did was pack it in a box and send it off and just wait for it to sell. It did take a little bit to sell, but I mean, with that kind of payout, I don't mind it at all. Another thing that sold, which was so exciting, because I actually found this at Goodwill for like $8, I think, it was this Chanel vintage sweater. It sold on The RealReal for $381.50. I was paid out $228.90. From $8 to $228, like, I just cannot believe it. I was honestly not sure if this was authentic, so I sent it in just to kind of, you know, cover my butt and not sell it on my own, because I was just way too scared of anything happening, but I was so, so, so happy with that sale. The last sale that I want to mention was this Celine vintage knee-high skirt, which I believe I picked up in a Jo Mar advanced CPR box, and it sold on the platform for $180. I was paid out $108. So honestly, most of my sales on The RealReal are not that much. Like above this, I sold an ALC skirt for I got paid out $6. Christian Dior jacket, I got paid out $65. But I just think that The RealReal is good if you have luxury or high-end items and you don't want to sell them yourself, or maybe you have a lot on your plate and you just kind of want to delegate some of that to somebody else. It's just a nice, slightly semi-passive income. I know it's not actually passive income, but removing all that work of like photographing, listing, shipping, and all of that kind of takes some of the work off of your plate. All right, you guys, I'm sorry for the change of scenery and the weird lighting, but somebody started using a leaf blower outside, which I'm sure you guys probably heard through majority of when I was talking, but I decided to move down into my living room so that I can finish sharing all of my data with you. I didn't realize that the closet insights on Poshmark completely clear when a new month starts. You no longer have access to see how your previous months do, which is kind of a bummer. You can only see like your current month or current year. It would be nice, Poshmark, hopefully if you're listening, it would be nice to look at individual months even like from the past. So like it's November now. I wish I could go back and see all of my October insights, because that would give me a better understanding of what I should do this month. But until they fix that, I'm just gonna be going over my full year because it's pretty much the same. I mean, it's been pretty much consistent. As for the top selling brands, I mentioned them a little bit when I was sharing my top sales with you guys. Those were the brands that brought in the most money for me. As for quantity, I sold a lot of Lululemon. I sold a few Sorel boots. And then of course my typical top brand is Free People. And whenever I see other people share their closet insights, it seems like a lot of other people have Free People as their top brand as well. The main thing that I wanted to share with my insights was the order insights. So if you look on your closet insights page, I'll pull it up right here. There's a little pie chart that shows what percentage of your sales are sold by offer, from buy it now, by bundle. According to my chart, approximately 68.85% of my sales come from offer. So whether that is me sending an offer to a liker or a customer sending an offer to me, 68% of my sales are made that way. 23% of my sales are from buy it now, which is not a lot. It's less than a quarter, but I have 6% from bundle offer, meaning that somebody's creating a bundle in my closet and then making an offer on that. And then 1% of my sales are bundle buy now, means that they make a bundle and then just press the buy now button without making any additional offers. Now, I think that this is important because I have a bundle discount set in my closet, an automatic discount that is added when somebody adds items to their bundle. Now, with this data, and I'm seeing that people aren't really utilizing that discount, I'm probably just gonna take it off, because when people do add things to a bundle and they see that discount, it kind of makes them maybe not want to purchase, or maybe wants to lowball me. I'm not sure what is going on there, but with this data that I'm getting, where I only have about 7% of my sales coming from bundles, I don't know how much I'm going to utilize that. Now, of course, Poshmark just came out with the My Shoppers feature, which I haven't really looked at yet, but it essentially allows you to send out offers to bundles in bulk. I feel like it has potential. I would just have to kind of play around with it and see what is the best way to use it. If you guys have used it and you guys have made sales from it, please let me know any tips that you have that we can share with everybody. But overall, I think that the My Closet Insights tool is extremely helpful. Again, I just wish that you could look at the previous month. I know that you can compare 2 months, but you don't get to see all of the data from the previous month. But a couple more things that I wanted to share on my personal numbers. Now, these are going to be numbers from a spreadsheet that I keep myself. This is not just Poshmark. This is going to be all the platforms that I sell on. Like I said earlier, I made a total sales in October of $6,756.61. Now, my average margin, which I don't think is super important, but I feel like a lot of people do care about that, is 64.15%. Now, my average for the year to date is 58.5%. So October was significantly better than like my year average. My average sales price also went up. This wasn't my highest month for average sale price, but it was one of the higher ones. And my average sale price in October was $43.31. My average profit per item, which is what I'm really trying to increase, was $27.78. That $27.78 is the highest profit per item that I have seen this year, at least. So I was very, very, very happy about that. Again, I want to get that number higher. This is my opinion, so if you disagree with me, that's totally okay, but this is just what I'm trying to do for my business. I think that the more profit that I can make per item is more important than the average sale price or the average profit margin, because I could sell something for $100, but if I paid $80 for it, you know, it doesn't really matter because I'm only making $20. I'm trying to focus on increasing my average profit. So that doesn't necessarily mean that I have to buy low or sell high. It just means that the items that I'm buying have to have a good return on them. So like recently I've been trying to pick up a little bit more expensive items, for me at least. Like I bought 2 pairs of shoes for $50 a piece, but I should be able to sell them for over $150 each. So that would be really exciting. That would be like $100 per shoe. But that sums up my analytics for October. Now, moving into November, I just want to take the momentum that I have from October being my best sales month and just push it through the end of the year. We have something like 60 days left of the year to get everything done. So I am ready to put in the work and just smash my goals. Some of the things that I am going to be working on this month are to hire a new VA, because the one that I had previously, we just weren't on the same page. It wasn't right, and that's totally fine. I think it takes a few tries to find the right person for your business. So I have to go and find another VA. I'm using Upwork to find people to work for me. It's been a pretty simple process. It's just the, I don't know, I just get kind of anxiety about like trying to choose the right person. But I gotta do that and study up on. Luckily, I can read through people's bios and see what kind of work they've done just to make sure that it is on par with what I'm looking for. Other than that, I'm going to practice relisting more frequently. I just went through and I had things that were listed for like over 150 days, which is like 4 months, okay? So I want to try this. I'm not sure if it's actually going to happen, but I've seen some other people post that they relist their entire closet every Sunday. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do that exactly, but I want to make sure that all of my listings on Poshmark do not exceed the 60-day limit. So once it hits 60 days, I want to relist it. I also, like I mentioned earlier, want to cross-list more onto Depop and cross-list more consistently on eBay, because I think consistency is definitely what brings in sales. If you're only posting for like 5 days out of the month, it's not, even if you're posting in bulk, I don't think that that's going to bring you the same kind of sales, whereas if you post a little bit every day, I feel like that triggers the algorithm a little bit more. Now, my monetary goals for November are to hopefully, I mean, I don't know if this is going to happen, but I'm going to aim for 7,000. That has been my goal for this whole year, is to hit $7,000 a month. I'm gonna be honest, that the real payout, that $600 definitely helped me a lot this month, but without anything being sent to the real, I'm not sure where else I'm gonna recoup that money. So I'm gonna try to just keep on cross-listing, keep on listing. I do have a trip planned for the middle of this month. I'm going to be going back to San Diego and to Las Vegas to visit some family. So while I'm in San Diego, I am hoping to hit up all of my old sourcing spots and just grab all that good stuff that I know is waiting down there for me. So hopefully that will help me achieve my goal of selling $7,000. I'm also just a couple thousand dollars away from breaking $100,000 earned on Poshmark, so I'm pretty sure I will at least hit that this month, which is very exciting. I mean, it's taken a few years for me to get 100,000, but hopefully once I hit that, the next 100,000 will come quicker. But that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know how your guys' October was and what your goals are for November. Let's all keep each other accountable down in the comments. And remember, if you guys want to sign up for Vendu, their link is down below. And you can also join our November listing challenge. It is completely free. You just have to have an active Vendu account. So I'm really looking forward to having accountability partners, essentially, because I feel like that definitely helps achieve our goals. And that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm sorry I've been kind of off the grid with my posting. I know this past week I didn't do the best, but I'm back on schedule, and I will see you guys on Thursday for another video. Bye.